I'll talk today about SAS Visual Forecasting 8.4 on Viya 3.4. Here we see the SAS drive. Up here on the left, I call this the hamburger. There are three horizontal lines. When I click that, I get the left menu and I see Build Models. If I click on Build Models, it opens the Model Studio or Build Models interface, which is a pipeline interface where I can create models. Not only can I create them with the new project, I can also compare models. I'll start by naming my project. I'm going to select forecasting as opposed to data mining and machine learning or text analytics. And I'm going to use the auto forecasting template. Although I have a wide variety of templates here, you see base forecasting, demand classification, hierarchical forecasting, among others. I'll stick with the auto forecasting for today. Now I'll browse to my data. I'm going to select the price data, which is a data set that's available with SAS Help. Once I'm in my VF project, I have five tabs at the top. You can see I have data, pipelines, pipeline comparison, overrides, and insights. My date has come in automatically with a roll of time. I'm going to select cost and make that my independent variable. I'll deselect that and then scroll down to find sale, which I will make my dependent variable. The dependent variable is what I'll be forecasting. I can also create a hierarchy. I'll select region name and then product line. These will be my buy variables. I can see that my reconciliation level will be top down, top, then product line, then region name, and I'm going to leave it the default of top down. Now I go to my pipelines tab. If I right click on my data tab, I can run that. I can also use the time series viewer now that I've run my data tab to see what my data look like over time. I can see that I have on the left attributes that I can select. So for example, region 1 has only line 1. If I select region 1 and region 3, I have a number of product lines and I can sub-select those. So here I'll click line 5 and line 1. So you can see I can subset my data any way I choose. Here I have the range, the two standard deviations, and one standard deviation. And actually I see nothing goes outside the two standard deviations in this particular data set. The dotted line is my actual data series. From the data tab, I can right click and add a child node, for example, a forecasting model, or I can go to the left where I have all of my forecasting models also there and I can drag them and drop them. I'll drag a panel series neural network over. So now you see I have two different modeling nodes. On the right, I can see that by default, my auto forecasting includes exponential smoothing models and ARIMA models. It by default does not include a holdout sample, and the default model selection criterion is MAPE, or mean absolute percent error. The panel series neural network, which was new in SAS Visual Forecasting 8.3, lets you use neural networks to create a forecast. I'm going to leave the defaults here, but if you're knowledgeable about neural networks, you can go in and change those. I'll look at the results of my auto forecasting. It starts with a summary page. I also have an output data tab. Here I can see my MAPE distribution. So I can see that 40% or two of my five series, here you can see the number of series is 5, I can see that two of my five series had a MAPE with a mean of 3.0395. Then I can see I had one series in each of the other bins here in my histogram. I can see that all of my models were exponential smoothing models, 100%. And I can see that 80% of my models had a seasonal component, and 40%, or two of the five, had a trend. Now, we notice that these are not mutually exclusive. I can have a model that is both seasonal and trend. So I can look at my model comparison results here, and I see that the champion selected of my two nodes was the auto forecasting node. And I recall that the auto-generated model included exponential smoothing and ARIMA, and I can open that code with the code button. Here you see that PROC-TS model is the main procedure used in forecasting. Here I'm requiring ATSM, or automatic time series model package, beginning with the submit statement is my user-defined code, or in this case, it's actually user-defined through the interactive interface. So the interactive interface has built this code for me. I could also cut and paste this code if I'd like into a SAS program if I would like to modify it and use it in another manner. I can also modify it here. And you see the end submit is the end of my user-defined code. I have a number of outputs that I send out: forecasting, statistics, the selection criterion, and my model information. These are output as tables. When I go to my pipeline comparison tab, I see that I have only one pipeline here, so that is the champion. I can see my MAPE distribution for that pipeline. I go to my overrides tab, and here is where I can override future forecasts or any value in my time series. I can go ahead and override that value and see what my resulting forecast, how that would change my resulting forecast. I type into a cell. Then I submit all. And you can see how this has changed my forecast. That's a little summary of SAS Visual Forecasting 8.4. I hope it was helpful.